So we built this site. Originally, it's the bottling water plant on the left-hand side. We produce Kavalan water, natural mineral water, and then we choose this site to build our distillery because of its very beautiful environment, and also it is rich in water, the very pure and very creamy, and also very plenty of the water. So we choose this site to start our distillery.
So you use the water you have for the water bottles for the distillery as well.
Yeah, that's right. And you can see the snow mountain is the second highest mountain in Taiwan. It's 3,800 meters, even 100 meters taller than Mount Fuji. So it calls snow mountain because in winter time, even in subtropical of Taiwan, it can be covered by snow on the top of the mountain. So that is why we got so plenty of the water from these mountains. And we just have to drill about 25 meters and then we can get very pure water. So now you can see we have two maturation warehouses. The second one we just built in 2016. So that also propel our production capacity because we also add the second distillery as well. So now we have total is 10 pairs of Scottish pastilles in our distillery. We can produce 9 million pure alcohol a year, liters of pure alcohol a year.
That's a big distillery, isn't it?
Yeah. So when we just finished our construction of the second distillery, we are the ninth largest distillery in the world. So actually, if you look at our maturation warehouse, it's the only one left to nature. Other part of the distillery is almost computerized and automated, but in the maturation warehouse, it's all it's the manual.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So a lot of staff will working inside, and in summertime, you can see we trying to shut most of the windows to trap the heat to create the greenhouse effect inside of our maturation warehouse. It can help extract more wood compounds and also get the color for our whiskey. And in winter time, we will try to open the window to let the cold winds from Siberia come in to help the circulation and also help the oxidation for the whiskey so that all the wood-related compounds can mix with our spirits very, very well. So in summertime, it's like you cooking a gravy. As longer you cook, it becomes sticky and very flavorful. But in winter time, it's like mixing all these flavor compounds back into the spirits. So that is very beautiful. That is why Kavalan whiskey is both color in the great color and also very aromatic and very flavorsome.
Tell me, the maturation here is faster than in Scotland.
Yeah, so it's also, we evaporate a lot during the summertime because the extreme heat actually help to speed up the time for maturation, but we also, the angel share is up to 10 to 12% a year. So as in Scotland, it's 3 to 5% a year, but our risk is, it's very easy to overaging our whiskey. So we have to check frequently to bring the sample from the maturation warehouse back into our lab to do the chemical analysis and also do the nosing by our master blender. This is our first maturation warehouse. You can see on the first floor, we only have bourbon casks, the smallest one, 200 liter, 220 liter placed in this floor. And you can see we palletize it and tied it together for preventing it from falling from the earthquake. So you can if you walk inside, you can find it's very, very warm. Usually in summertime, it can reach 30 degrees Celsius on the first floor. And if you go higher, go to the third floor, it can be 35, and the fifth floor can be 42 degrees Celsius. So we kind of have a strategy for storing all these casks. It's the smallest one we will put on the lower floor, and the highest level will be sherry butts and pork pipes, 500 liter, 600 liter cask.
And you bind them together everywhere in all warehouses because of the earthquakes, right?
No. So on the lower level, it will be palletized, but if you go higher, it's Danish style.
Ah, okay.
Yeah. So as you see, this is shaving. And then we will see toasting and recharring. This is a treatment we invented with Dr. James Wan, especially for our wine cask. Because we source our wine cask from all around the world, from France, and United States, and Portuguese, and also Australia. So we have to secure the consistency and the quality in the cask, so that we invented shaving first. Shaving, we have to remove the interior side of the wine cask for a very thin layer, and then it will reveal the original color of the wood. That can help remove the sourness, the off notes from the wine cask in the maturation. And then we will go through the toasting part. And this is the second part. We will gently toast the cask at about 250 degrees Celsius. And then it can bring very nice vanilla and oakiness and the roasted baked flavor in the cask. charring, we put intense fire into the cast to burn into a crisp. That created the very great charcoal there inside of the cast. It can remove the undesirable particle during maturation, and also it can bring very nice caramel flavor to complexify our whiskey flavor. So that is our wine cast. How Vinil Varick, the world champion, come to be this? This is Spirit Castle. On the first floor, we have a public tasting area. We offer any visitor come to the distillery one shot of Covaland Classic for free. So a lot of people will queue there to try the free drink. And on the second floor, we have the Mr. Brown Cafe. It's a very great place to take your time to enjoy the coffee. This is public tasting area. People can queue in the line to get one shot of Covaland Classic for free. And we also provide the nosing samples for them to nose the other type, other different expressions of whiskey. Also display the non-PT mode and the PT mode. And two types of dry yeast. And the cast we use bourbon cask, port cask from Portuguese, and brandy cask from France, and vinho cask, wine cask from all around the world. And this is showing the how we made the sherry cask. So it was made of American oak, and we will put the sherry wine, produce sherry wine inside and empty it and ship back to Taiwan. This is Fino sherry, but because under the climate of Taiwan, the floor is easily disappearing. And a different level of charring. From the lightest one to the heaviest one, you can see it's like a crocodile texture inside of the cask. And you can also touch the wood. We display the same new make in different type of cask, and we compare the outcome from the different casks. For example, the port cask, it can be very, very dark within 4 years. But for bourbon cask, it can be a very beautiful amber color at the end of maturation. Amontillado, Fino, and Oloroso sherry cask. And this is, want to show you the angel share. In Taiwan, goes through 6 years. Actually, we lose 10% every year. And at the end of 6 years, it can last only 2/3 in the cask.
It's a massive loss.
Yeah. And the wash bags, you can see, and the mesh tons.
This is distillery number one?
Number one.
So practically people can walk through the distillery.
Yeah, can learn more about the producing process. It's a beginning, middle, and the end of the maturation of fermentation. On the right hand side, these are the oldest costume we have in 2005. When we built the first distillery, we already have these two pairs of Scottish costumes.
They are smaller in size? They are smaller than the...
No. All the wash suits, they are identical, same height, same shape, and same size. And these are the stews we imported from Germany. At the beginning, we used this to produce the new make for whiskey, but we found it's light and not rich enough, so we repurposed these stews to produce Kaplan gin. We have 6 small containers at our site, and after we import the barley from England and also North Europe, we will store here, and this extends to the production line.
So these are the mountains you get your water from, right?
Yes, Snow Mountain, the second highest one. So after rain falling in the mountains, it will go through the layer of the earth and then absorb as much as minerals in the water, and then it enhances the fermentation later in the producing process. go through double distillation. The first distillation, you can see our wash still with the window one. And the second distillation will be used as spirit still. And now it's coming out, it's four shots and fans. You can see the spirit stay. So we will cut the finest part during the second distillation. Cut the narrow cut of the heart, as the heart to get into our cask.
And they're made in Scotland by Forsyth.
Yes. Because it's too hot and humid, so we not only have one condenser, we have a sub cooler to support it, to make it cooler.
Mash tuns a little bit.
Yeah. So for mashing process, before that we have to mill our barley first. So we have the certain particle size, the core, floor, and fine, and we have certain percentage to make sure it will have very good efficiency during the mashing process. So we will cast this grist into the mashing tuns and put in 3 times hot water, that is from 65 to 90 degrees, getting up. And then after that, we will get very high quality wort.